amazing Ospreys. Today is Tuesday, December 18th, and we saw a lot of holiday hats out there. Well done, Curtin. I am Taylor Smith.
Tomorrow will be a red-green day, so I hope to see you wearing these holiday outfits around the school. And I'm Kenya.
Today we'll continue with special announcements and showing those amazing videos for you guys.
Today we will talk about bullying, flag football, and the Teacher of the Year.
Get ready to see some students, teachers, and administrators being a part of our stories. You could be one of them.
But before that, don't forget this important announcement.
National Junior Honor Society is still collecting your new or gently used washed coats and hoodies. To the stage in the cafeteria, please put them there and they will be donated.
Donations will be taken until this Friday, December 21st.
Well, let's go with our first video, continuing with the topic, bullying.
Aaron Valdano was out there talking to students and teachers about that. Let's check this out.
Today we are going to be talking about this whole week, well, and probably for all the years, bullying. Bullying is a problem that occurs when two people, the bully and then the person that gets bullied, where they're having conflict with each other. We're going to be having interviews with different types of people who have experience with bullying or who are the bullies and what they should do. So, see you guys in the next interview. Hey KMS News, I'm Aaron and I'm here with
Alden Hannah Jr.
So today our topic is about bullying. Do you have any experience with bullying?
Yes, I do.
Wow. How did you stop the problem?
By telling my dad what was going on in school.
Was it hard to, tell your dad?
Yes, it was, because I didn't want to be so-called a snitch.
Did the problem get, was it calm after that?
Well, it was a little bit, but then it had more effect on it because I had told somebody, and it put me more in a dangerous situation where somebody would jump me as if I was, I have had some things wrong with it.
But the problem got solved in the end, right?
Yes, it has.
So do you feel safe now? Comfortable?
Yes, I feel way comfortable.
What's your name?
My name is Mr. Zelski.
Do you have any experience with bullying?
I certainly do. Both as a former middle schooler, I dealt with it, and most definitely as a counselor. I've helped a lot of students with it.
Yeah. When they come to you, what do they ask you?
Well, biggest thing is if anyone's ever being bullied, they should feel like that they can go to a trusted adult and tell them. I'm a trusted adult. I mean, really, any of the adults in the building are teachers, Mr. Michael, Dr. Moore. We're all trusted adults. And anytime bullying has taken place, you can always come to us. You may feel like sometimes that it might get worse if you do, or sometimes kids these age use the words tattling, or if not, even snitching. But anytime there's bullying going on, and you tell an adult about it, that's not snitching. That is reporting, because you have every right to feel safe and that something's going to be done about it.
Is there any other ways that they could get help to stop the bullying?
Well, honestly, I'd say one of the biggest helps, is beyond just what the adults can do, is you guys, the students. Students can help each other out. They can help each other out by not being a bystander, not just standing by watching it, or even worse, getting involved in it. Even better, they can be an upstander. They can help stand up for someone. And the biggest way you can do that is think, man, if that was going on, if that was happening to me, what would I want someone else to do about it? And then do that.
That's all we have today, KMS. See you guys next time on KMS News.
Thanks, Aaron. That was awesome.
Bullying is always a hard topic. Remember, we don't accept bullying.
Students, don't forget, we have Kernan's talent show on Thursday at 5:30 p.m. in the cafeteria. The price is $3, and there will be treats to purchase as well.
An encore performance will happen on Friday during school for $3, but only for students who have not received any referrals and meet the tardy requirement.
Now it is time for our second story of the day.
Do you remember the school flag football event? Kianis Forgo was there to give us some highlights of the tournament. Let's take a look.
Hi, I'm Kianis, and this year is another game of girls flag football. The contestants are the Amazing Ospreys, Outlaws, and Patriots. Here are some shots.
It's cold outside.
That was very good, Kianis. Thanks for that report.
That day was fun, really fun.
In the other topic, the next Amazing Ospreys event will be on Thursday. You need to complete at least 12 Achieve articles at 75% or higher, or complete the required iReady minutes at 70% or higher.
Accelerated math students will also be eligible to attend. You have until tomorrow to meet the tardy requirements. VIP status and other perks for the talent show will be a part of the reward.
Attention Ospreys, Kernan Middle School 2018-2019 yearbook is on the sale, and the cost is $25.
You may purchase online using the school name. Ask in your house office for more details.
Okay, what is coming next is amazing. We're talking to you about the video of the day. We're going to celebrate the Teacher of the Year at Kernan, and we are talking about Miss North, one of our science teachers.
Liliana McGuire and Summer Ligon are going to tell us the story to celebrate Miss Norris's achievement. Let's see this.
Hey KMS, it's Kernan News, and today we'll be interviewing Miss Norris, the Teacher of the Year, Miss Henfield, and Miss Norris's students. Sunny's
the teacher of the year. Well, Miss Norris was selected for Teacher of the Year this year because she has the respect of her colleagues, parents, and stakeholders. Other teachers nominate teachers for Teacher of the Year, and then a selection committee of community members, teachers, and administrators observes classrooms and chooses from those.
Is there anything that Miss Norris does differently than any other teacher?
I think part of Miss Norris's success is her personality. Miss Norris seems to have a great way of connecting with her students, and she's obviously really into Star Wars and Harry Potter and things of that nature, so she has a youthful spirit and connects well with her students.
Do you think that Miss Norris's attitude has led to her success?
I think so. Miss Norris comes in every day excited about her classes, about her students, about inspiring them to learn, and she's very hardworking, so a positive attitude can take you really far.
Do you feel any connections with Miss Norris?
I feel like Miss Norris will really help you with any of your work that you're doing, and that she's very nice to all of her students.
Yes, she's a great teacher. She helps you with your homework or whatever you need, and she's always there.
Definitely. She's a great science teacher. I love science, and she makes me love it more.
She's a very happy person, and she'll be able to do anything for you.
She's a great, funny teacher. She always makes you laugh, even if it's not really that funny. And even if it's really corny, you still have to laugh.
Very funny person. I mean, I love her to death. Like, she makes all the work fun and just hilarious. She's got a bunch of corny jokes that I think are just funny. Sunny's
the teacher of the year. She will help you with the stuff, and she'll help you, like, she'll teach it to you in a good way. She makes the work fun, and she makes it funny, and she always makes you laugh.
Okay, she has a really good way of connecting with all of her students, and she makes it easier to adapt to the science environment of her class. Sunny's the
teacher of the year. So, what do you love about your job?
I absolutely love teaching science. I love working with the kids that I work with. I love making science fun. I set things on fire because it's fun. We've dissected eyeballs because it's fun. I like to compare things to superheroes and Harry Potter because it just makes science alive and it makes it just really interesting for them to learn.
What personality trait do you think a teacher needs to have to succeed?
Definitely you need to be caring. Definitely understanding. Sometimes when students leave the school, things happen outside of school that we don't know about. And so we need to understand that outside of school, that life continues. And we need to be prepared to teach not only our curriculum, but be there for those students. And also adapt, because sometimes we have lesson plans and things change, and you have to be ready to adapt to those changes.
Is there anything you want to change at Kernan?
I think it would be really cool if we didn't have building 8, 7, 6, 9, but if we named the buildings and we let the kids name the buildings. So the kids in those buildings got to pick a name and vote on it, and maybe even the art club design a banner for the building that says represents that we're House Slytherin or whatever it is.
Is there any teacher that you look up to?
My favorite teacher of all time is Miss Otley Fisher. She is the head of the dance department at La Villa, and she was my 9th grade science teacher. And she, a lot of the things that I do with trying to make things fun and interesting and funny, she also did in the classroom when I had her as my science teacher.
What a great story! Thanks, Liliana and Summer.
And that was all for today, Amazing Ospreys. I hope you enjoyed the news today.
And get ready, because in Ospreys News, we have more videos to share with you.
And don't forget to wear red and green tomorrow to celebrate holidays.
See you next time.